In the alternate version of 417, we're going to calculate both our current ratio and also our acid test ratio. I will point out the current ratio itself was covered in Chapter 3, but we're going to go ahead and cover both of these ratios in this problem in order to compare and also contrast how they look at measuring liquidity or the ability for a company to meet its short-term obligations. You know, how they have similarities and differences between those two ratios. We're going to go ahead and jump into calculating first our current ratio, which if you recall is total current assets divided by total current liabilities. Now we have a setup of our problem here, and we're going to do a comparison between case X, Y, and Z. In this particular problem, they've already been nice enough to total up our current assets. For example, case X is $3,000 of cash, short-term investments of zero, current receivables of $400, inventory of $2,600 and prepaid expenses of $1,800 is going to give us total current assets of $7,800. And the problems you get may not be as nice to go ahead and give you that subtotal. So remember the concepts from our classified balance sheet in Chapter 3 to be able to identify which items fall within current assets. Also, they've been very generous to go ahead and give us a subtotal for current liabilities is going to be $2,900 in the case of X. Again, you may instead be given a list of different liabilities and have to indicate those yourself. So if you recall, items like accounts payable, wages payable, interest payable, and other types of current liabilities fit within that current liability category. Remember, the distinguishment current and non-current is, are we expecting to either use that up? Is expectation that it's going to become due within that 1 year, normally that 1 year operating cycle time frame? So be comfortable identifying those if you have to. Let's go ahead and jump into case X, the current ratio. Total current assets of $7,800 divided by current liabilities of $2,900 gives us a current ratio of 2.69. It indicates to round our ratios to two decimals, which we did correctly. So this company is pretty strong in terms of having a really sufficient cushion of assets that can either be used up, converted to cash, whatever it might be. In order to satisfy those current liabilities, it has a pretty strong cushion of liquidity according to the current ratio. Case Y is going to have current assets of $5,850 divided by current liabilities of $3,000 is going to give us a current ratio of 1.95. A little bit lower, but still that overall threshold, if you recall, is usually one, at least one, as many current assets as I have current liabilities, so it's definitely above the overall threshold of one. Case Z is going to have current assets of $6,500 divided by current liabilities of $3,800 is going to give us a current ratio of 1.71. So all of them are over the threshold. In this particular ratio, normally a larger number is better. So we have to do a comparison from just this ratio alone. We would say that case X is in the best position so far to meet its short-term obligations. But let's look at what we either call the acid test ratio or also known as the quick ratio. This ratio has some similarities and differences with the current ratio. The difference is the numerator is not total current assets. Instead, it's something called quick assets. But the denominator stays as current liabilities. So we still have a comparison to our short-term obligations, those things we think we're going to have to satisfy within 1 year. But instead of comparing all our current assets, we're going to look at those, which we call quick assets, those most readily able to convert to cash. That's going to include three major categories: cash itself, short-term obligations, things that investments we have that we think that we convert to cash readily, and also current receivables. So oftentimes a major category within there is accounts receivable itself. You know, we're expecting to be able to collect from our customers within 15 days, 30 days, 90 days in a fairly quick time frame. Those are all considered to be total quick assets. If you notice, we do exclude two major categories that are current assets themselves that are not quick assets, and that's going to be inventory and prepaid expenses. Those are not as easy or readily able to convert to cash in order to satisfy our short-term obligations. If you think about it, inventory, we're first going to have to sell it. Then after we sell it, we're still going to have to collect cash from our customers. So again, not as readily able to satisfy our short-term obligations. So let's start our calculations of quick assets for X, cash of $3,000, short-term investments of zero, current receivables of $400, and total quick assets, if we add the three of these up, is going to be $3,400, divided by our same current liabilities of $2,900, and our asset test ratio, if we round to two decimals, is going to be 1.17. I will also point out that we can indicate here that normally the asset test ratio is going to be lower than the current ratio. It's either at least going to be the same or definitely typically going to be lower in most situations. And if we think about that, the reason why is it's excluding some of those current assets that are included in the numerator in the current ratio. So it's excluding inventory and prepaid expenses. And most companies are going to have, even if I'm a service company, I'm not going to have inventory, but I'm typically at least going to have prepaid expenses. So for most companies, the total current assets is going to be greater than the quick assets. So for most companies, the current ratio is definitely going to be higher than our asset test ratio. So we expect that. An overall threshold for this one is we also typically want the asset test ratio or the quick ratio to be above, to be one or greater. We want enough near-term cash to meet those short-term obligations. So let's look at case Y. Cash of $400, short-term investments of zero, current receivables of $1,250. Adding those up, we get quick assets of $1,650. If we compare that to our current liabilities, we get a quick ratio of 0.55. That is definitely below one. That could potentially, and I say potentially, be a credit risk for a company due to potential liquidity problems. Now, it depends. If these current liabilities are due farther out, 9 months, 10 months, 8 months, nearer to that 1 year time frame, then you know, we might still be able to convert most of our other, like our inventory, those type of items to cash in order to satisfy them. But if that's not true and those current liabilities are due more in that 3 month, 6 month time frame, this may be potentially a sign of liquidity problems. Let's look at case Z, cash of $1,500, short-term investments of $900. Current receivables of $1,200 mean we have total quick assets of $3,600. When we compare that to current liabilities of $3,800, we're just slightly below the one. So not a huge red flag, but slightly below in terms of 0.95. It would just be something that we would want to monitor over time if it continued to decrease. We might get into more and more liquidity problems. Now, from this standpoint, if we compare the companies just on the basis of asset test ratio, case X is going to have the highest one, which is going to be the best position to meet its short-term obligations. It also happened to have a current ratio of the highest. So overall, when we're asked which company is in the best position, it's definitely going to be case X, just based on these two ratios alone. If we're asked, which we weren't in here, which is going to be in the second position, you might have initially said Y due to a current ratio of 1.95, but remember the asset test ratio is much lower. It could potentially be a sign of problems. So my argument would be, I'd argue that Z probably is in the second position, even though the current ratio of 1.71 is a smidge lower than the current ratio of 1.95. It has almost double, not quite that, an asset test ratio. So that one appears to be in a better position to meet those short-term obligations.